because I don't need neither one of y'all for shit, and you're not going to sit up here and talk condescending to me either, because yes, I am a strong woman, I am a powered woman, and I don't take shit off of no. I don't give a f- my daddy, my brother, my man,
why sitting
next to me on stage. I don't give.
Listen, this is a question that you said. Why are you mad at us for that?
All right. What's up, YouTube? It is your boy once again with another episode of Foreign. All right, so let's just jump right into this. Ladies, please tell me this. Why, when you try and get your point across, you got to scream at the top of your lungs? Why is that? It's always the shortest, too, but you ladies just have to scream to get your point across. And I'm trying to understand why you do this, why you use so much profanity, and why you think this is a way to talk to men. So this is where we at on this. This young lady came on this panel to talk to these two gentlemen, and all you can hear was a bunch of disrespectful, over-talking, loud, belittling, hyena screaming woman. That's what we got out of this. So I want y'all to see it for yourself. But before you do, make sure you hit that subscribe, like, and share. And let's check this hyena out and let's see what's going on. Why is she so angry? But y'all got to see this, man. You got to see.
This is what I'm saying. Are you willing to listen to what a man say he wants and apply to those things without any, like, you got to
rebuttal.
Exactly, rebuttal.
Hell no.
That's bullshit.
Hell no.
Why?
Because I know.
I'm saying if he take care of you, he take care of your necessary needs.
I'm an empowered woman. Does it really matter what you do for me?
Alpha woman.
Because I'm able to do it for myself.
Alpha woman.
And if kissing is required.
What? That ain't got nothing to do with it. That ain't kissing.
I just said I don't like
that. Ain't. No, we ain't talking about no right now. We done got over that.
Like,
he asked you a question that you're trying to get away from.
Now, check out all the cursing, the profanity that she uses, and check out how she avoids the questions. She'll deflect in a heartbeat because she only wants to talk about what she wants to talk about. She don't want to hear what they talking about. Just watch.
Ask you some dumb shit and get you confused, because we get confused easy. A man confuses real easy.
Mm-hmm.
And she tried to.
Now, she fucked me up quick. Glad you called it.
If a man asking you for things, can you talk about his feelings without bringing yours up?
Sure.
Shit.
Boy, you that shit did not sound confident. Shit. Like, goddamn.
Listen.
Oh, okay. So why didn't that? You listen, but would you comply? Would you understand?
I would understand, and I would comply if those things are within reason. For me.
You know why y'all can't hear sometimes? Because y'all listen to rebuttal. Mean? Y'all don't listen to understand nobody.
No.
We're not in the 60s, baby. We are in 2024, which is really equivalent to 2054. We're in a new age now. The future is feminine. Why the you think I must cater to what your needs?
And she got the memo about the feminine part. You don't sound feminine, young lady. And a reference with 2054... 30 years from now? Why? Why? Y'all just sound stupid. Like, damn.
Sorry.
Nobody ain't say that.
Let me tell you what we're going to do first of all, what we're going to do is talk about my needs. Nah. And once my needs are met, then I'll think about meeting your goddamn.
I'm going to
tell
you.
This is what you call a grooming woman. She's a groomer. She want to groom a man. No,
that's right. I do.
This is what
I do. I build a man and I make him into what I want him to be. That's what I do.
God damn.
How long you been in your relationship now?
90 days.
90 days.
Yes.
Boy, that's a rough one. That's a rough 90, but I'm going to tell you this right here.
Don't tell her about your feelings.
This is the reason.
Now, you hear that mess she just said? Now, her man is sitting over there. See old dude on the left? I put an arrow by him. He looked over at him when she said that. And she been with the dude for 90 days. 3 months, and basically, she grooming to do whatever she says. So right there is a sign of disrespect. That's why dude looked at him. It's like, dang, you gonna say this when old dude sitting right there? Like, wow. Better run, brother. You better run while you can. You see what's happening.
that old civil rights bullshit and all that old woman bullshit. This is the reason why shit right now.
Mm-hmm.
You know, y'all talk about the ladies in the 60s and the 50s and shit like that, but they had real families and had real wealth and had land and everything.
Damn right.
Yeah, because my great aunt, shit, called me when I was damn near, 40-something, talking about selling some land they had for years.
Yeah, but those women were severely suppressed.
You say that. Those but women they were severely.
I am my not. Aunt, my we're aunt not sold suppressed
that.
Anymore.
But you say
those women
suppressed.
Were severely suppressed.
Okay, give me an example of one.
Meaning that word listen.
A lot
trigger,
of them were not able
women.
To step out and use their creative gifts for what they want to.
What do you mean?
They were only able to use them to build a home.
Okay, how many women got creative gifts? Give me
a.
A
lot of women
one.
Have creative gifts. A lot of women are running successful businesses. Me building a home, or cooking your food, or ironing your clothes. Mm-hmm. Not just about that anymore. Women are using their energies and their power things for themselves. That women back in the day prayed and wished they could do.
Okay, so.
What, have you seen The Color Purple?
Nope. I don't even
you haven't seen The
shit.
Color Purple, not even the new one.
I saw
I don't
okay.
like that shit.
If you look purple. At it, CeeLo was in a relationship with Mister where she was suppressed as a woman. Creative gifts, but she could not use her gifts for what she wanted to do because every time she felt empowered, he would drain her energy from her body, climbing on top of her, her. Anytime a man is climbing on top of you, and he don't believe in you.
Excuse me, little angry woman. Why do you have your finger in my face and why are you raising your voice? That's what I'm trying to figure out.
He don't believe in your dreams. Mm. He'll make you late for your shit.
Okay, first of all, let's just jump on this. Ladies that like to use color purple as a reference, that was a scripted movie. From the beginning to the end, someone wrote it. They wrote a happy ending and everything. It is not a true story or only based on a true story. It is as fictional as fiction can be. Now, the other thing is why she called out her man over there. She looked at him and screamed at him like, you purposely tried to make me late for something, I guess, coming to the shoot. But did you see her face? Look at her face. Look how she's frowned up. Look how she's looking at her dude. Couldn't be me.
That's a problem.
Mm.
That is a problem. Damn. A woman needs a man that makes her feel empowered. Meaning if I tell you I got something important I want to do in my life, you are helping me get there to my goal. Because mm-hmm. that's what she's supposed to be doing with him. Correct?
Mm-hmm.
So...
Okay.
This when CeeLo left me.
You see that little thing she's doing with her hands? I wish they would have checked her on that. All that talking with her hands and pointing in their face and all this and directing how she talking to this and that. That tells you a lot about that lady. She screams, fuss, and directs everything she talks about. Like you call them, we used to call them back in the day hateful. That we used to call them back in the day. Just a little hateful little woman. That's what she is. Because every time she talks, she this, and she like this, she automatically does it. So it's just something in her. When she talks to people, that's how she talks to people. She don't give nobody no respect. But I guarantee she wants somebody to give her respect.
When Suge Avery came and helped CeeLo feel empowered as a woman, CeeLo opened her own business.
Mm-hmm.
Her own business.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm
tell this nut the movie wasn't real. She think this was something that happened for real.
A lot of women are feeling trapped in relationships with men because we give so much of our energy from our sacral chakra, our sexual chakra. We're giving away our power and our energy to men who don't even believe in us. Men who won't even get us there on time.
Okay, who picked them?
That's a problem.
Who picked them?
No.
It ain't about who picked who. Did you pick them?
We picked each other. What do you mean?
But you saying he's sorry and all this old bullshit, but you were
nobody said anything about anybody being sorry.
I'm saying,
she's describing a sorry dude. So that's why a dude said that. And you keep referencing how you got there late or some didn't get there on time, which you keep looking at your dude. So you saying your dude is sorry because he couldn't get you on time because he was purposely trying to sabotage your whatever. Sounding crazy as I don't know what. But you keep disrespecting your dude in there. And it's disrespectful how you talking and all that profanity with these men. That was, see, she don't understand that. She's trying to be on their energy, like, dudes, you're not a guy. You shouldn't be up there screaming and yelling and flexing like you a dude. Slow it down. Damn. Y'all ladies try so hard to be men.
Saying he don't believe in you. You said he didn't believe
women,
in you.
Women, when you feel empowered as a woman more without a man, you're not going to really want one.
But this is what I don't understand. Hold on, hold on.
If you feel more empowered without a man, you're not going to really want one.
Let me ask you this. Why would a man not believe in you if he going to get in shit with you? Give me one that would get in a relationship with you and don't believe in you. Shit, I
there
never
are plenty of men out here who are getting in a relationship with a woman, life. But sabotaging her at every chance that he gets.
What you mean?
What do you mean?
Drake, Blake, have you ever met a like that? I ain't never met a like that ever in my life.
You have some women that want to work and their man don't want them to work. Like back in the 60s.
Yeah.
There were women who wanted to work, their man did not let them work. Yeah. That's sabotage.
No, it's not.
Yes.
Hell no, it's making
so 30-something-year-old women need to stop trying to reference something 30 years ago, before most of them before they were born. A lot of people didn't, a lot of women couldn't work because there was no daycare back then. And somebody had to stay home with the kids. So the guys went out and worked. They stayed home, took care of the kids because it was a lot more than just cooking for the man. They had to cook for the kids, clean their clothes, all this other stuff. She just only referenced a man, but you forgot. They had children. She didn't just take care of him. She took care of the children and him and the home. But you new women don't know how to do that now because y'all too busy running around, want to get a degree and be a serial entrepreneur and don't know how to clean freaking house. That's what's going on now. Majority don't know how to clean a house. And we know half of you can't cook.
Should he make sure that another get his goddamn woman? He
you see,
ain't that
that's
damn
sabotage. That he insecurity.
Real. Nah, that
security, sabotage for being the best version of herself that she could be.
What you
that's
just,
the shit that I'm talking
man,
about.
You just want freedom.
You want your woman to stay home, hidden in a closet from any other man getting her attention.
Bro, she look crazy as I don't know what, doing all that screaming and yelling. I mean, she's screaming at the top of her doggone lungs. She sound like something out of an old slave movie that's trying to rejoice or something. Sounding crazy. Y'all sisters just don't know how y'all be sounding out here. Thinking that's empowering. Yelling and screaming at the top of your lungs in a room full of men.
But you want to be a wild ass, a hyena, and get in the damn streets with them other ragged.
Can I?
That's what y'all want to do.
A woman wants to shine. Man, star
y'all want to get in these packs like y'all
sometimes
hyenas.
Women want a shot. Let me tell you, first
come
of all,
on,
I'm not a woman that hang in packs.
I'm saying, but most of
I'm
we talk about
female,
most of these women.
I don't even
we
need
talk
a pack.
About, but
I don't need
no
giggling
thing.
Behind my back.
It's no such thing.
I don't
thing.
Got no female friends because that's how they are.
It's no such
they
thing.
They giggle in your face. They giggle behind your
back. Here's that thing. They think it's something proud to say, I don't have no female friends. Why not? Why? What is going on where you ladies can't associate with each other? So y'all so bad that y'all can't get along, but you expect a man to get along with you. You probably don't have any friends because of your mouth and that attitude. Nobody's sitting around for that. And I'm telling you now, a lot of dudes not sitting around. You probably got a lot of dudes you might think in the friend zone, but they probably friend zone you. But I'm pretty sure I don't even know how this dude that you got sitting around there for 90 days even dealing with this. Like, ain't nothing attractive about this.
Listen, I don't need them.
Listen, there's no such thing as an alpha female.
I'm looking for, this is the reason why it's so important to me, why having the right man in my life is so important to me, because he is supposed to be my ride or die.
Okay.
I don't got no group of riding with me.
Okay.
He riding with me.
That's cool.
And I don't need them.
You talk to him
so
like this?
That's why it's important for
but
him to be
talk
that
to
kind
him
of
like
partner
this?
For me.
Do you talk to him like this?
Like what?
Like how you talking to us right now. Do you talk to him like that?
You over talking.
Yeah,
tell me a lot of women.
Yeah,
look how she looked at old dude when he said that, because she thought she was really doing something in there. She didn't realize that she was being disrespectful.
Maybe you talk to him
like
that.
I'm gonna tell you something,
and you expect him to be a ride or die for you.
Can I say this? I ain't gonna say a lot of women.
You.
I was sitting here listening. There's no way in the, because I done dealt with this.
Mm-hmm,
there's no
too.
Way in the
me
fuck.
Too.
I'm gonna sit here and take you serious. You're doing this shit to me. I got a mama, or had. I don't need another mama. I need a partner. Partner or anything. ain't going to talk to me and make me feel this big. First of all, I want to touch on something you said earlier. I'm glad you went in like that. I want to touch on something you just said a few minutes ago. Mm-hmm. We're getting here.
Yeah.
We're getting here.
Let me finish. I don't want y'all to think that I'm talking down. I'm using it because I'm trying to belittle my man in front of here.
Oh, he hit it on the head. That's exactly what you did. That's exactly what you're doing. You've been belittling your man the whole time you've been in there with that mouth. But you continue on.
Listen, we're telling you how we feel about it.
Y'all notice how she reaches over. Now, that's a violation by itself. She reaches over and touches dude's arm to keep him from talking. Why are you touching this man? Why is your hand on this man and your man sitting over there? You see all the wrong that's going on? All this masculine energy she putting out? And if it, actually, I'm not even saying it's masculine because men don't touch other men in conversation like this.
Making sure you understand that when a woman has a vision and a plan for where she want to go in her life, she don't need a man telling her, oh no, you don't need to go on
She can
stage.
Do it in the inside voice.
She don't need to go on
Voice. Yeah, what's wrong with a regular voice?
She can talk in a regular voice.
When a man talk loud, he's confident. When a woman talk loud, she's just loud.
Yeah, because you know why? Because women ain't supposed to talk like that.
So can I finish?
Correct. You ladies aren't supposed to be in the middle of a conversation screaming at the top of your lungs, especially in a room full of men. Your essence alone and your femininity should be enough. All this yelling, screaming, all this facial stuff, pointing, touching. No, you in the wrong, lady. Check yourself. Get yourself right. You said you're supposed to be basking in your femininity in 2024 to 2054. We need to see that because we don't see it.
Y'all.
You're right.
Both of y'all, if y'all think that I'm up here being some type of way because I don't need neither one of y'all for shit. And you're not going to sit up here and talk condescending to me either. Because yes, I am a strong woman. I am a empowered woman. And I don't take shit off of no. I don't give a f- be my daddy, my brother, my man.
Well, why
sitting
mad
next
at
to
us?
Me on stage? This I don't
Listen, this is a question that you said. Why are you mad at us for that?
Listen, I'm about to roll out because I don't like feeling disrespected. And y'all not gonna sit here and tell me I disrespect my man because I'm using that as an example of me being late today. Y'all not gonna do that. You're not gonna do that on air. You're not gonna do that to me, period.
I don't know if this chick came on the show, had a plan, like I'm just gonna go off and act a fool and trying to be viral, not knowing that these guys sitting there collecting all their information is like, why are you disrespecting your dude like this? Why are you talking like this to a bunch of men? Do you talk to your man like this? So you got him looking like, damn, I brought you here, and the only thing you can do is sit here and show me how less you care about me? Like, she was straight disrespectful the whole time. Nothing she said made sense. All she did was scream at the top of her lungs and look like a fool. That's it. That is it. And you ladies do this shit all the time. This is how y'all look when y'all out here thinking y'all standing up to a man, sticking your chest out and bulging your eyes. This is how you look. You like a damn fool. Well, God, that's it on this, man. I'm going to try to find a full video. I might be some more on this chick, but that was enough because she made such a fool out of herself. And I think she realized at the end when she's like, I got to get up and go. You done sat there and been disrespectful to your man. He might be a good dude, and you might have messed up, and you realized it. So you're like, I need to get up out of here. Or maybe the dude got up and walked out. You know what I'm saying? So all I can say is, man, ladies, y'all got to stop trying to be men. Y'all got to stop trying to be men because y'all look stupid. You look stupid. But either way, that's it. And it is your boy, Mr. Nobody. And I am up out of here. Y'all stay vibing. Peace.
All right.